We want the shortcut to the winner's podium. And sometimes, you know, when we don't get that short-term glory that we want, we lose track of those long-term goals. And you look up and in 6 weeks or in 6 months or in 6 years, and you've made no progress. None. You never moved. You might even be further from your goal than you were. Why? Why did you let that happen? It's because you lost sight of that long-term goal. And at some point, after you lose sight of that goal and years have gone by, you think to yourself, maybe I can't. Maybe I can't do it. And so you give up. You let it fade and you settle. You settle for mediocrity, you settle for average, you settle for, oh well. But no, no, don't do that. Embed that long-term goal in your mind, burn it into your soul. Think about it and write about it and talk about it and hang it up on your wall. But most important, do something about it. Do something about it every day. Every day, do something that moves you toward that goal, that keeps the goal alive and in sight and in focus. However small or insignificant that step might seem, take it. Do it. Do that little piece. Make it happen. Because that goal isn't going to achieve itself. It's all on you.
One of the things you can be virtually certain of in life is that you don't get something you don't aim at. And one of the things that's interesting about that is often people will keep their goals fuzzy. Because one of the problems with specifying your goals is you specify your failures. Right, if the goal is really fuzzy, you're not sure when you fail, and that then you can fool yourself. You know, really, but you can kind of keep it foggy. But you make your goal sharp and clear, then, well, first of all, then you know what to aim at. And what's interesting is, you know, your brain is set up so that it reorganizes the world around your aims.
Yes, it's possible that you can choose your future and direct the course of your life as you run toward your dream. It's necessary that you have goals, that you write those goals down, that you plan, that you think constantly of how you can begin to improve what it is that you're doing. If it's your presentations, if it's your recruiting skills, whatever that is, it's also necessary that you look for ways to always find a way to pull it out when everybody else thinks that you are defeated. That you've got to take personal responsibility to know that in order to become successful, you've got to make it your personal business. To do it.
Aim high, but use as your control yourself. It's like, so your goal is to make today some tiny increment better than yesterday. And you can use better, you can define better yourself. This doesn't have to be some imposition of external morality. You know where you're weak and insufficient, where you could improve. Think, okay, well, this is what I'm like yesterday. If I did this little thing, things would be just an increment better. And well, that's a great thing because you get the ball rolling, and incremental improvement is unstoppable. You can actually implement it, and it starts to generate Pareto distribution-like consequences. It starts to compound. The goal should be, how could I conceive of my life so that if I had that life, it would clearly be worth living, so I wouldn't have to be bitter, resentful, deceitful, arrogant, and vengeful? Like, that's sort of the bottom line, right? Because that's what endless failure does to you. It's not good. And that's what life without purpose and a goal does to you as well, because life is very hard. So you think, okay, well, I need to adopt a mode of being that would justify my suffering. And you can ask yourself that question. What would make this worthwhile?
It's not what you get that makes you valuable. It's what you become. So part of the key here is to set the kind of goals that will make something of you. Don't set them too low. So that you don't have to grow, and you don't have to read, and you don't have to try, and you don't have to stretch. Don't set them too low. And then don't sell out. Don't go for something that's going to cost you your virtue or cost you your values or sell out your principles. There's a good middle road here to follow. Goals that will inspire, goals that'll help you grow, change, develop, and become better than you are.
You gotta make a decision. Listen to me. You gotta make a decision. What's the decision? What's the thing you came here for? Now we're at the moment. The clock is ticking. People say all the time, hey, life is short. Let me tell you something. Life can be long. You bury your dreams, you quit this, life gets long. See, time's relative. 2 minutes of you being with your sweetie, doing whatever you like to do with them, that can go by quick, right? What's about the last 2 minutes on a treadmill? Does that not seem like it goes by for like 4 hours, right? So if you're enjoying it, it's short. If it's painful, it's long. Life can be long. See, there's a book being written about your life. Someone somewhere is taking inventory of your life. Don't compare your chapter 1 to someone's chapter 10. You write your own book. And at any moment in your life, you can decide that you want to make this the new chapter. You're literally in your life, you can turn the page. And those previous chapters are your old book. It's like Old Testament, New Testament. Old story, new story. They're connected, they're related, but you can flip the page and you can have a whole new story. If you decided right now, I am literally turning, my breakthrough is I turn the page, and in this second, I start to write the best chapters of my life.
It's possible for you to live your dream. It's necessary that you associate with winners, that you work your system, that you are relentless, that you never give up. It's you. You've got to take personal responsibility. You've got to make it your personal business to make it happen. And you've got to resolve within yourself that I can do this, that it's hard, but you've got to say, I'm the one. I'm the one to make this happen. I'm the one to become successful in this business. As you work to help other people to become successful, that feeds your success. But you know it's going to be hard, but find out what will make it worth it for you.